This episode is sponsored by Brilliant.
How hard is it to cover your face? For me, it's easy because I have a lot of masks, which means I also know how inconvenient they can be. They make your ears hurt, no one can see you smile, not to mention the humidity. But we're in the middle of a global pandemic, and that's also been pretty inconvenient and tragic. And this piece of cloth is one of the best tools we have to be able to socialize, go shopping, and get back to normal safely. We know that masks help slow the transmission of COVID-19 without affecting your oxygen supply. Oxygen molecules are small enough to pass through the masks, and surgeons wear them for hours at a time. Wearing a mask helps you from getting sick, and it also protects others if you have the virus but you're not showing any symptoms. Wearing a mask protects you, but it also protects your community. And there are lots of fun designs for everybody. Masks do help, and they look cool too. Please join me in wearing one so we can see our friends, travel, and get back to enjoying life again, safely. Slow the cases, cover your faces. Recently, you may have seen some ads or GIFs or images similar to that masterpiece. Except public health messages that actually share statistics and data aren't as effective in getting people to change their behavior. Now, I know that a lot of you like statistics, you like data, which is why you watch this channel. So here are a few stats for you. 40% of people who watch this video will be in the United States of America. And in the past 14 days in the US, there's been an 80% rise in new COVID-19 cases. So it's likely that you're more interested in science and technology than other people you know. So because of that, I need a favor. I need you to talk to others about how they should be using a mask to slow the spread of COVID-19. And this isn't just limited to the US. Other countries and areas have rising COVID-19 cases too. In New Zealand, which is almost COVID-free, their prime minister recently said this.
As a nation, we are extremely fortunate to be supported by our science experts and science communicators.
I have never heard a world leader use the term science communicators, but she's right. Science communicators are super important, and people get their information from all different places, including friends and family. And you could be that person. So I need you to be a science communicator. You have been watching YouTube videos about science and maths and whatever else for a little while now, so you could argue you've been training for this moment. Here are 6 tips with a sprinkle of scientific research on how you can effectively share this message. It seems logical to think that people are self-interested, that we all just want to protect our own health. But a recent study found that people were more likely to wear masks when the message focused on your community compared to your family or your country. We tend to underestimate our risk of getting a disease, and perhaps thinking about your country is too large of a scale. So thinking about using masks to reduce the impact on your community has the most impact. Throwing facts at people makes them easy to ignore, and shaming people often makes them more polarized. Just giving people information and giving them knowledge isn't a good motivator for them to change their behavior, as we can see by health messages on products that people just continue to buy. And people act less rationally when they consider health choices, like choosing or following a healthy diet, compared to other choices, like thinking about the best transport option to get to work. Add it up. Another mistake is framing behavior change as common sense. So saying, wear a mask, it reduces cases, it's just common sense. Because if it was common sense, most people would already be doing it. And behavior change is actually super complicated, so it doesn't help to make it sound simple and effortless. We often don't change our behavior because of mental barriers we have that can then affect our confidence that we can change our behavior, which is actually a really, really big factor. So if I decide that I don't want to exercise because exercise is uncomfortable, then I'm done. I've made up my mind. But to change and build up the confidence that we need or other people need to do so, it helps to address those barriers, to figure out what they are and what we can do about them. And in the case of masks, addressing that they're not perfect or addressing whatever someone's particular concern is about them may help. If we don't acknowledge people's concerns, like the discomfort, then people will hold on to that. So get to the bottom of it. Ask, why are they uncomfortable? What are you experiencing? Does it make your ears hurt? Can we get you a mask that doesn't make your ears hurt? Are you not going to help your community because your ears hurt?
That one was probably a little judgmental.
If you're honest and real with people and address their concerns, it can help give them more confidence that they can change. There are a lot of unique challenges with this pandemic and the environment we're in at the moment, but there are some similarities we can see with efforts to slow the spread of other viruses in the past, like using condoms to slow the spread of HIV in the 80s and 90s. In the 80s, messages that shamed people for engaging in unsafe sex or played into their fears, like this poster of a gravestone, weren't that effective. Trying to motivate people by talking about risk and disease doesn't work that well. Campaigns that were more effective talked about sexual pleasure and safe sex side by side, so it didn't seem like they were mutually exclusive and they went hand in hand. Think about comparing wearing masks to other behaviours that you already do automatically to protect yourself and other people, like food safety and refrigerating meat, or wearing a seatbelt, or wearing sunscreen. And I'm sure that over the course of your life, you've seen commercials encouraging people to do these things. Now, if you think about wearing a seatbelt, for a lot of us, it's an automatic action when you get in a car to stop your car from nudging you to do it, but also because of the ads that we absorbed when we were kids.
Front and back.
How can you forget about click, clack, front and back? But you don't wear a seatbelt because you're a bad driver, necessarily. You wear a seatbelt to protect yourself from other drivers who are more unpredictable that could harm you. Kind of the same way as you wear a mask to protect yourself from other people who could be carrying the virus. You wear sunscreen to protect yourself from a danger that you can't visibly see, and this stops you from experiencing some discomfort in the short term, but also from experiencing any complications down the road. To a virus. Of course, using seatbelts and sunscreen took people some time to get used to, but they work and now they're pretty widely accepted. But only in 1983, this is nuts, in 1983, 15% of Americans said that they wore a seatbelt. Some people opposed mandatory seatbelt use then, but now we barely think about it. Actually, in a popular clip of a guy who was arguing against mandatory mask use, you can actually see he's wearing a seatbelt. That one was a little judgmental, but I meant it. Being nice helps if you're trying to persuade other people. It makes you more friendly and approachable. So don't be a dick. And on top of that, be persistent. Within reason. The more times that people hear a message, the more it's normalized and the more they're willing to accept it. So slow the cases, cover your faces. When you take all of this into account, you can see how this ad...
Lakeland has 114,000 reasons to mask up, but the only one you'll need is probably right next to you.
Might be more effective than this ad. In curbing the spread of the virus. Thinking back to all of those other examples, at this point in 2020, if we are asking people to stay home, it's not gonna work. It's like asking people to abstain from sex or to stay out of the sun. It's more effective if we humanize messages about reducing risk. If we focus on pleasurable, enjoyable social interaction, the things that most people want, and we add masks, and we add distancing, and we add washing hands and avoiding crowded outdoor spaces, it will be much more effective. Wearing a mask is actually super patriotic because it protects your fellow patriots, and it is very helpful for your community. Now you have some tips and it's over to you. You're a science communicator. Please share this message. And this year has really been a year of graphs. So if, like me, you want to brush up on your statistics, Brilliant is the place to do it. Brilliant is the maths and science enrichment learning platform that I use it for daily challenges and short courses too. I like Brilliant because they make things easy for all different levels. So if you're a bit rusty like me and you need help, it's just a click away, or you can level up from a daily challenge to a short course. If you want to master science problems every day, go to brilliant.org/braincraft and sign up for free. And also, the first 200 BrainCraft viewers that go to that link will get 20% off their annual premium subscription.